Welcome back to the IBSP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
You are now witnessing greatness. Canelo Alvarez, Anthony Joshua are once in a generation type of fighters. And what does it mean to truly be a great fighter? A great fighter is absolutely free smoke. They don't duck, they don't dodge, and they don't run from challenges. A great fighter is a champion who beat another champion, who's not looking for vacant belts. All champions are not created equal. You know, a great fighter is looking for prime fighters to fight. A great fighter is looking for undefeated fighters to fight. A great fighter is looking for dangerous fights to fight. A great fighter is a guy whose resume is elite, showing they're consistently fighting top-level fighters and world champions. And a great fighter is focused on history, not just money. Let's just break it down. Canelo Alvarez fits this description. Why does he fit this description? Because he's absolutely free smoke. You know, Canelo Alvarez in the past has offered Callum Smith a fight, and he rejected a career-high payday with Canelo Alvarez. So did Billy Joe Saunders. Even Triple G rejected the trilogy fight with Canelo Alvarez. Archer Beterbiev, Canelo Alvarez reached out to fight him before he even reached out to Sergey Kovalev, and they had plans. You know, Canelo Alvarez reached out to Jermall Charlo's camp, and they turned down an opportunity to fight Canelo Alvarez. Caleb Plant turned down the smoke twice, ducked Canelo Alvarez twice. These guys simply understand that Canelo Alvarez is a great fighter in search of greatness. And then you see Anthony Joshua. You know, you see Jarrell Miller shot up every drug in CVS to avoid Anthony Joshua. You see Tyson Fury turned down an Anthony Joshua fight. Deontay Wilder turned down an Anthony Joshua fight. Luis Ortiz, Adam Quinocchi, and even Dillian White all turned down the Anthony Joshua smoke. And here's the interesting thing about AJ and Canelo. You know, Canelo Alvarez fought and beat an undefeated world champion in his prime in a unification fight, showing that he truly wants to be a great fighter. Anthony Joshua has literally did the same thing in the same parallel. You look at it like this: Anthony Joshua beat an undefeated world champion in his prime in a unification fight. These guys are a lot alike because when you witness greatness, they seem to come in pairs. When you look at it like this, both of these guys beat challenging fighters in impressive fashions, yet people continue to make excuses just to try to discredit their wins and downplay their success. Only casuals are fooled by haters. And look, let me break it down even more. Canelo Alvarez has the best resume in boxing of any prime fighter. No one is fighting his level of competition on a consistent basis. He's pound for pound number one and is not even close. We all know it's Canelo Alvarez, but yet you still have some people saying Terrence Crawford is number one pound for pound. You still have biased media pumping him up. And at the end of the day, what you see and you understand the reason for this is they're simply Canelo Alvarez haters. There's no other word for it. They're absolutely biased because anybody with a brain that's not a moron, idiot, or a dummy understands that Canelo Alvarez is pound for pound number one. Even Terrence Crawford's own mama know Canelo Alvarez is pound for pound number one. Let's just not be biased. Let's be honest. Terrence Crawford is a great fighter. He's an elite fighter. He's a talented guy, but he simply doesn't have anywhere near close to resume. He's even stated that, you know, his best win at welterweight is Jeff Horn. Come on now, let's just be honest and unbiased. Canelo Alvarez is far ahead, number one pound for pound fighter in the world. Anybody saying different is a fanboy. And then on the other end, you see Anthony Joshua. This guy has 10 times better resume than any active heavyweight. He holds every belt in the division except for one. Anthony Joshua beat a Hall of Fame, you know, Vladimir Klitschko, with zero suspicion of taking a PED, while Tyson Fury beat Klitschko, ducked the rematch twice, and has a huge suspicion cloud of taking a PED just to get the win. Anthony Joshua has defended his belts, showing that he welcomes all comers. Tyson Fury has never done so. Anthony Joshua has literally faced top fighters with multiple styles and came out on top, while Tyson Fury beat Deontay Wilder, who had no skills and was the biggest hype job in boxing, and fanboys and biased media elevated this guy to the number one heavyweight division, the number one fighter in the heavyweight division off that garbage win alone. Are you serious? While Anthony Joshua clearly has the best resume in the division, consistently taking on the most dangerous fighters after fight after fight, and he continues to get no credit. Let's just be honest. You're witnessing greatness with Canelo Alvarez, with Anthony Joshua. Both of these guys are the ones who are pushing for undisputed in their respective division. Tyson Fury came out before and absolutely stated that he does not care about being undisputed. He does not care about holding all of the belts at one time. I mean, if you look at his most recent fights and his most recent resume, aside from Deontay Wilder, you see that Tyson Fury has been facing nothing but Uber drivers, gardeners, refrigerator repairmen. I mean, look at it like this. Tyson Fury's resume outside of Wilder in his last 4 to 6 fights: Sefra Safari, Francisco Pianeta, Otto Wallin, and Tom Schwartz. Does that sound like a guy that wants to be great, that wants to be undisputed? Most recently, he agreed to terms with Ajit Kabiyal, his sparring partner, another Uber driver, before Anthony Joshua entered the picture. Come on now, let's just be honest. It's clear that he simply wants a massive payday and is motivated by money, while Anthony Joshua is belt collecting and he's motivated by legacy and greatness. Now, with Canelo Alvarez, it's absolutely the same thing. You see he's motivated by legacy. You see he's motivated by being great. Because, you know, Caleb Plant, you know, David Benavidez, Billy Joe Saunders, and, you know, Callum Smith, none of these guys were really looking to unify. They were all talk. None of these guys were doing anything to make any significant moves before Canelo Alvarez stepped foot in the division. All of these guys were okay facing low-tier fighters. But at the end of the day, you see, as soon as Canelo Alvarez came to 168, he immediately starts looking to unify and setting up fights with literally every champion in the division. Because men lie, women lie, but the facts don't lie.